Hi guys, welcome to AdSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir with a new video, and in this video I'll show you guys how you can add payment icons to your card drawer of your Shopify store. So pretty simple, easy to learn tutorial, and we will be doing that without using any app. And after you are done, that's how it's gonna look like. So that's my development store, and if I click on card icon, you can see that below proceed to secure checkout I have these payment icons showing up. And you can also change the payment icons. So if you want to remove Apple Pay or add Union Pay or add any other icons, you can do that very easily just by following this video. And again, don't forget to subscribe the channel, because once you do that, you will have a lot of free tutorials in your premises where you can add this circle menu. You have this YouTube autoplay video showing up on your store. You have this cool looking collection slider. We have this pie chart and a whole lot of customization, which I have taught in this channel completely for free. You don't have to pay anything in order to add these UI features to your store. And this is a lookbook section, right? A really cool looking lookbook section, which you can also add. There's before after slider. So all of these features are completely for free. So once again, make sure to subscribe the channel. Okay, now let's proceed with the tutorial. Now first, what I'm gonna do, I am going to install a fresh Sean theme so I can show you guys how it's gonna work on your fresh Sean theme. So let's go to the back end of the store and then click on online store. And from here, I am going to install a fresh Sean theme. So let's click on add. And our fresh Dawn theme is being installed. Guys, while this theme is being installed, if you are new to Shopify and you want your Shopify store for just $1 a month, there's a link in the description. If you sign up through that link, you will get your store for just $1 a month. It's a limited time offer, so make sure to sign up now, because Shopify keep changing their promotions and this is a limited time promotion. Link in the description for just $1 a month of store of your Shopify store. Okay guys, our Dawn theme is still being installed. Let's see how long it's gonna take to be installed. Okay, it's completed. We have Dawn 15.2.0, which is the latest version. Now let's click on publish and then click on publish again. Okay, our fresh Dawn theme has been installed. And now when I preview this store, clicking on three small dots and then click on preview. And if I go to my cart drawer, okay, it's not opening up the card drawer. I'll have to enable that from customize settings. So let's enable our card drawer. Go to settings and then from drawers. Oops, not this one. Card. We want our drawer. And then let's click on save. Perfect. Now let's check out our card drawer. So there's our card, click on that, and here's our card drawer. Okay, now below our card drawer, you can see that we have a checkout button, but we don't have any payment icons showing up, not like we had it here, right? So I'm gonna teach you guys how you can add these icons. So now let's go to our code editor, click on these three small dots, and then click on edit code. Before editing the code, make sure to have a duplicate of your theme. And how can you create a duplicate? It's pretty simple. So if I go back to themes again, and okay, my theme limit is reached. So I'm going to remove an older theme in order to just show you guys how you can create a duplicate. It's really important to have a duplicate of your theme. I'm going to remove one of my older theme because there's a limit of 20 themes which we can add on our store, right? And now, let's suppose that's your live Shopify theme and you want to have a backup of it. All you have to do is just click on these three small dots and then click on duplicate. Once you click on duplicate, it will create a duplicate of your live theme. So if you mess up anything in your code, you can simply click on publish again and revert it back. It's that simple. Make sure to do that before editing the code. Okay, now let's get back to the code editor. Let's click on these three small dots and then click on edit code. Okay. Before editing the code, guys, we have created an app for you guys, which is called Big Bulk Discount. This app is going to add a feature of volume or tier-based discount. So it's really helpful for you to increase or boost your Shopify store sales by incentivizing your visitors to add more products to the cart. In this screenshot here, we are giving it, if someone add two products to the cart, it's going to get 10% discount. And if someone add three products to the cart, it's going to get 20% discount. You can add another tier as well. Like if someone add five products to the cart, you can offer 30% discount. So this incentivization makes your user add more product to the cart, boost your store sales, and also increase average order value. Link in the description. 14 days free trial available for this app, so you don't have to pay anything for 14 days. You can use it completely for free, and if you see it's giving you a boost on your store sales, you can continue to do so. Okay, now let's get back with the tutorial, and we will search for cart drawer snippet. So that's our snippet, which is cartdrawer.liquid. We will open this snippet and we will search for slash cart drawer. Okay. And above these div and above this second last div, we are going to add a line break, right? So make sure to count that cart drawer and then what first div and then second last div, then add a line break above that. And now we will add some code. Code is available in this blog post. This blog post is available in the YouTube video description. You don't have to pay anything for that. You don't have to subscribe to any sign up or any newsletter. Just click on the link in the description and you will land on this page, and we will copy this code here. So click on copy code and then paste this code here. Perfect. After pasting the code, hit save. And now if I open my store and hit refresh, open the cart drawer, you can see that these icons are showing up, right? Now, what if you don't want the Visa or you don't want the Master or you want to replace it with something else? We have a whole lot of icons. If you scroll down to the bottom of this blog post, which I have linked in the description, you can see all of this list here. So we can add Amazon, we can add this UnionPay, Mastro, JCB, Diners Club, Ideal, Facebook Pay, all available. And you can also replace that. How you can do that? So the code which we pasted has this line here, right? We have Visa, Master, Apple Pay, PayPal, and Google Pay. That's what we have showing up here. Visa, Master Pay, Apple Pay, PayPal, and Google Pay, right? Now, if I want to replace Google Pay with Union Pay, I'm simply going to remove this Google Pay and copy the Union Pay code from here. Here's the Union Pay code. And then paste it here and then click save. Now, if I go back to my store and hit refresh, open up the drawer again, hide this bar, you can see now Google Pay has been replaced with the Union Pay, right? Now, what if you want to change the position of it? You want to Union Pay to be showing up first and not the last. You can simply cut paste it and move it to the front. So I'm going to cut and paste it on the starting of this line and then add a comma, remove this last comma from this line and then click save. Perfect. Now, if I go back and hit refresh and open up the cart drawer, you can see that Union Pay is showing up at first, right? So it's that simple. You can simply copy and paste the code and add this to your cart drawer to display this. Now, what if you want to add a condition or customized settings where you want to enable or disable it in future? You can simply do that by wrapping this code in the if condition. So I'm going to add an if condition, if settings dot payment underscore icons, and then I'm going to end this if after the UL, right? And then click save. By the way, this if condition code is also available here on the blog post, so you can see here. So I just wrapped the previous code, right, in the if condition, and now I'm going to copy this JSON code on my settings underscore schema or JSON file. And let's open up the settings underscore schema. Okay, where's my schema file? Here's the schema file, settings underscore schema.json file. I'm going to scroll down all the way to the bottom and add code here after the line break. So copy this code and paste it here. Perfect. Now let's hit save. And now when I go to customize, let's open up the customize. That's our theme customizer. And here now if I go to settings and then scroll down to the bottom and check the cart, we have this additional option showing up which says show payment icons. And if I simply disable that and hit save, also save the code. Okay, code is already saved. This code is also saved. Now if I hit refresh and check out my cart drawer, you can see that the payment icons are not showing up. Now all I have to do is simply enable this from here, save again, and then open that again. And you can see that our payment icons are showing up. Cool, right? So that's it for the tutorial, guys. I hope you guys like it. Let me know in the comments below if you want to learn more anything about Shopify. I would love to create more tutorial for you guys. Until next video, have a great day.